Okay, let us start today's class. I hope you have all seen the video that I have posted on introduction to the leaf spring, and you should have also seen the formulation of stress and deflection for leaf spring in the last class. And in that video also you should have learned about how the leaf spring is fixed in the vehicle and how it is serving the function. Okay. So now, you probably should have the understanding of how the leaf spring. So this is the leaf spring you can see that is fixed in a truck chassis. Okay, and the central portion will be fixed with the axle housing, and the end of the leaf spring, the eye portion will be pinned with the chassis. Okay, so what happens when you have ups and down on the road? Your tire that is in contact with the road, no, it will go up and down. So the vibration will be transferred to your axle, and when the axle is moving up and down, okay, so that vibratory motion will be transferred to this leaf spring, that is pre-bent leaf spring plates. So they will absorb that ups and down forces, and they will avoid the transformation of the impulse forces that are transmitted to the axle housing. Further, it restricts the transformation to the chassis. Okay, so how the leaf spring is functioning, and you can see almost the application of leaf spring in the automotives, like passenger cars, even trucks, small trucks, load vehicles, and buses and lorries. Most of them will be having leaf springs. Okay, so predominantly the application of leaf spring finds in automotive field. Main purpose is to absorb the impulse forces, the vibrating forces that are induced in the material, okay, the induced in the vehicle. Okay, so in today's class we are going to look at the problems from the leaf spring. Okay, for our problems that we are going to see in mechanics of materials, it is enough if you keep these two points in your mind, that is the formulas of our calculating the stress, okay, stress induced in the leaf spring and deflection of the leaf spring, these two formulas enough. Okay, so kindly keep these two formulas in your mind, and here the W is nothing but the load applied. Okay, L is nothing but length of the leaf spring or span of the leaf spring, that is this one. Okay, and then N is nothing but number of leaves. Okay, and B is nothing but breadth of the leaf. You know, leaf is nothing but a plate. Okay, so plate has a breadth and the thickness. T is nothing but thickness. Okay, so here in this equation, E is nothing but Young's modulus. You know that that is a material property. So only you have to aware of these two formulas to solve the problems. Very simple to solve the problems. Okay, you will be asked to calculate the bending stress or deflection. Or by giving these two, you will be asked to calculate any one of the parameters in the equation. That's all. Okay, so it's very simple to calculate all of them. So you know what is BNT? BNT is nothing but, so these are all the stacked plates. Plates are stacked on each other. Okay, so these plates, no, if you cut a small portion, you can find this, a small portion. Okay, this is nothing but the thickness. This is nothing but the thickness, and this is nothing but the breadth. Okay, if you look at it from the top view, you can see that. Okay, so this is what the formulation that you have to remember, and now you need to get into this problem number one. So what are the given data? If you see, a leaf spring is given and it carries a load of 3000 newton. Okay, it carries a load of 3000 newton. The leaf spring is to be made of 10 steel plates, so number of plates are 10. Okay, and the plate's dimension is 5 centimeter wide, that is width is B is 5 centimeter, and thickness is 6 centimeter. Okay, thickness is 6 centimeter, and further they have given the bending stress limited to means you should understand that the maximum amount of bending stress that is allowed in the material of the leaf spring is 150 newton per mm square. Okay, so maximum bending stress, allowable bending stress is 150 newton per mm square. Okay, so it is given in mm. So what you can do here, you should here 5 centimeter wide and 6 mm thick. Okay, always remember that the thickness will be less than the breadth. So this is in mm, this is in centimeter. Okay, so you can also convert this into centimeter. 5 centimeter will be 50 mm. Okay, so now they have they are asked to calculate the length of the spring. So what is the length of the spring? So here what is given in the problem, we should see that is stress value is given in the problem. Then you can comfortably go for the use of stress equation. So what is the stress equation? 33 WL 2 NB T square. So now what you want to know, you want to know the length, but you know W, you know N, B, T and sigma, everything. Okay, so substitute all the values. 150 is the maximum stress allowed and load is 3000 newton, and length you do not know, that you want to find out, and N is 10 and B is 50 and T is 6 square. Okay, so now if you rearrange this equation and calculate, you will find I'll just calculate. Okay, so 150 into 2 into 10 into 50 into 6 into 6 divided by 3 into 3000. Okay, so you get 600 mm as the length of the spring, or 0.6 meter. That's all. And what is the next thing you have to calculate? You have to calculate the deflection at the center of the spring. What is the deflection? So you know the expression for the deflection as well. And they have given the Young's modulus as 2 into 10 to the power 5. Okay, so now you also know the formula. You can go for the calculation. So what you do is, you apply the deflection formula, that is sigma L square divided by 4ET. Okay, so sigma, you know that is 150, L is 600 mm square divided by 4 into Young's modulus 2 into 10 to the power 5, and thickness is 6 meters. So if you calculate it, you get 150 into 600 square divided by 4 into 2 into 10 to the power 5 into 6. You get 11.25 mm. Okay, 11.25 mm is the deflection. Okay, so you got the deflection and length. Fine. So now the second one, second problem, if you look at the same two problems, two formulas you have to use. Okay, let us see what are the given data. The length of the spring is given, that is 1 meter long laminated spring. The leaf spring can also be called as laminated spring or semi-elliptical spring, like that. Okay. So don't confuse with the name. Laminated spring is also called as leaf spring. Okay, so the length of the spring is given, that is 1 meter, and it is made up of plates of each 5 centimeter wide, that is width is 5 centimeter, that is 50 mm. Okay, 1 meter means 1000 mm length, and the thickness is 1 centimeter, so 10 mm thickness. If the bending stress in the plate is limited to the 100 newton per mm square, how many plates would be required to enable the spring to carry the point load of 2 kilonewton? So point load is 2 kilonewton, that is 2000 newton. And you are asked to calculate how many number of plates has to be placed to withstand this load. So what is given in the problem? Sigma B is given. What is sigma B? That is stress. Okay. Then you can use the stress equation. So if you use the stress equation, sigma is equal to 3 WL divided by 2 AT square. 3 WL divided by 2 N BT square. Okay, so now you know what is the stress, and then you know the load, that is 2 kilonewton, 2000 newton, and length 1000 mm, and 2 and N, that's what you want to find out. What is B? That is 50 mm. What is T? That is 10 mm. So 10 square. So by rearranging, I am calculating the N value. 100 into 2 into 50 into 10 square divided by 3 into 200 into 1000. Okay, so I get 1.66. Okay, if I get 1.66 means I should take the immediate greater value. So I should take two number of springs to be used in this application, two springs, two plates. Okay, so now then what you have to calculate, you have to calculate the deflection again. So you know the formula to calculate the deflection. So del will be sigma L square by 4 ET, sigma L square by 4 ET. So you know what is E, Young's modulus, given in the problem, 2 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per mm square. So you know the stress, that is 100, length, that is 1000, 4 into 2 into 10 to the power 5, and thickness is 10 mm. Okay, if you calculate that, you will get 100 into 1000 square divided by 4 into 2 into 10 to the power 5, 10. Okay, you get 12.5 mm. Okay, so this is the deflection of the string. Okay, so that's all about it. We will get only simple problems from the leaf spring in the mechanics point of view. Okay, so you have to remember the formula for calculating the deflection bending stress. That's all. You can easily solve the problem from the leaf spring. So practice some more problems from the textbooks. As of now, in today's class, it is over. And do you have any doubt, guys?
No, sir.